In Blender 4.3, a new parameter has been added to the all-powerful Pincel BSDF shader. But what exactly does this parameter do, and how can we use it inside of our materials? Let's find out. To start off, let's add an object. So I'm going to press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm just going to choose UV Sphere. Then you can see it's a bit jagged, so I'm just going to right click and then choose Shade Smooth. Now this opens up the shader editor. So I'm going to change my timeline here by left clicking the clock and changing it to Shader Editor. And then I'm going to change this line style here to Object if it isn't already set to Object. This plus new button is going to allow us to add a new material. But if we add anything just now, we won't be able to see it because we need to go into the render preview. The reason we're going into render preview today and not material preview is because this new Pincel BSDF feature is cycles only, and we'll need to go into render preview in cycles in order to see it. So to make sure you're in cycles, come to this render properties panel, which looks like the back of a camera, and make sure your render engine is set to cycles. Then I can go ahead and left click this viewport shading, and right now we can't see anything, and to fix that I can just press Shift A, then under light I'm just going to choose point, and then I'm going to move it into place by pressing G and then Y, which is going to grab it and then move it across the Y axis. Once I've dragged my light out in front of my object, I'll maybe pull it up as well by pressing G and then Z, which is going to grab it and then move it across the Z axis, which is the up and down axis. Once I'm happy with its position, I'll left click to save it, and we probably need to go ahead and make it a bit brighter. So with my light selected, I'm going to come down to this green bulb option here called the data properties, and I'm going to be changing my power to something like 100. Also, to see my objects a little bit better, I'm going to go ahead and turn off the show overlays just so we can see it. We can also add a background as well if you like, by going to world properties, and then I can just press plus new, and I'll maybe turn my strength down to something lower like 0.2. I'm then just going to zoom into my object. Awesome, now I'm going to go ahead and left click my object to make sure it's selected, and I can go ahead and press this plus new button to add a new material. As you can see by default, it's added this Pincel BSDF shader, but if you ever want to add it yourself manually, you can do that by coming up to this add menu, coming to shader, and then choosing Pincel BSDF. You can also press Shift and then A in this menu and come to shader and choose from there. A bit like how in the 3D viewport, we can press Shift and then A to bring up the add menu for objects. And this new setting is called Diffuse. You can see we have another roughness slider, which is actually different from this roughness slider here. As a lot of you may know, this roughness slider is for controlling the clarity of reflections based on how rough the surface would be. For example, a roughness on this parameter of 0 would make our material very reflective. However, if I set this to 0, we're not going to see much because we don't actually have very much in our scene. But that's okay, since we're not really going to be demonstrating this roughness in this video anyway. I'll just set that back to 0.5. This diffuse roughness only works in cycles, so do keep that in mind. When it's set to 0, it's going to be using something called Lambertian reflection, which is a simple way of calculating how a non-metal is going to look. Since this is something for non-metals, when we set this slider to metallic, this whole diffuse slider here doesn't really become relevant to you, so please feel free to forget about this parameter when dealing with metal materials. But when should we use this parameter? Well, let's say you had a really rough material like a brick. That would be a good time to use this parameter. That's because when we set this roughness to something like 1, it's going to calculate the diffuse or non-metal reflections in a more physically accurate way using something called Oren-Nayer reflection. And pretty much what happens is when we set this roughness to 1, it enables the Oren-Nayer BSDF. BSDF just stands for Bidirectional Scattering Distribution Function. So all that means is when you're setting this to 1, we're enabling this new function, which gives us this more physically accurate appearance of our non-metals, particularly for rougher materials. For example, I would use this for materials such as brick, concrete, and things of that nature. So here you can see I've made this procedural brick material, and I'm just going to go into the shader node here and come to this Pincel BSDF, and if I open up this diffuse parameter, I could set this to 1 since bricks are quite a rough material, and this will improve the realism of our shader. After I've enabled it, you will notice the difference is quite subtle, but it's a great step in the right direction to improving your realism, and it's all these little touches added up together which can really make a big difference. On the other hand though, for this really smooth and reflective realistic plastic material we made in a previous tutorial, if I was to come down to the diffuse tab, if I was to set this value to 1, it could have a negative impact on how it looks on certain curved surfaces. So in my opinion, I prefer to just keep the diffuse roughness at 0 for more reflective surfaces like this. But this diffuse roughness is still great for using on those rougher surfaces like brick. However, as you can see here, this is only one of many different things that the Pincel BSDF can do. So make sure to check out my updated Pincel BSDF in-depth video to become an expert at using this node. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.